Alright, so here we are back in Adobe After Effects. I'm still using 7.0, and we'll just go composition, new composition, and we'll make it 1000 pixels by 1000 pixels and 10 seconds long. More than enough. And we'll go layer, new solid, and we'll make it white and comp size. Okay, now we got something to paste our paths onto. And usually you're just going to be pasting one thing at a time, but I'm going to make things difficult, and we're going to use that flower we did. You know, for example, one thing at a time, you'd bring this in, paste the paths into After Effects, and just scale it up as, you know, one thing, and then add it onto whatever inside. But if you want to keep something, you know, positionally together, say I want to keep, you know, this flower top, and I want to use it in different areas, yeah, may as well just copy and paste them all instead of bouncing between programs. So we'll copy all of them. And we'll paste all of them. And we'll hit M to bring up the mask, and we'll just start changing these colors so we can distinguish what piece is what piece, because that's kind of confusing when it's all yellow. And sure, why not? We'll have a pink one too. So we got this very colorful flower now. We can easily tell what's what. Okay, next step is to put them all on their own layer. So we'll go layer, new solid. And we'll make it white, comp size again. And we'll just throw it under here just so it's easier to work with. We got 7 masks, so hit Control D 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now bring open your masks again. And maybe twirly them all up here just so you got some more room. And just start copying and pasting these masks. So select the first one, Control C, and the first white solid down, Control V, and then delete it because you really don't need it there anymore. And copy, second one down, paste. And just continue along copying and pasting until they're all on their own layer. Good, and yeah, we got two kinds of animations we're going to do. So this one we're going to rename as Stem. The rest I know they're all leaves, so I really don't care. I'm going to pre-compose this once this is all animated, and then maybe throw it into another composition with all kinds of pre-compositions. Yeah, that's the basic idea. So we'll start with the stem. Anything like this, any stem, any stringy, like, you know, even these that kind of twirl around, and these stringies, as I said, we'll add a stroke type animation to them. So we'll just go effect, generate, right on, and we'll just lock this mask and take the pen tool and just make a quick path along, you know, doesn't have to be great, just along the stem there, and just hit Control C to copy, hit E to bring up the effects, and twirly down, there's the brush position, and Control V to paste. So over a 2 second period, this brush will move along that path, which is good. I mean, you can shorten it up, hold Alt and the last keyframe, and just tuck it in a little, so it happens a little faster, yeah, up to you. So yeah, brush size, we'll bring this up. Just big enough so it will fill all this in. And stroke length, we want to make this as long as the composition, so we can just overshoot that if we feel like. And paint style from on original image to reveal original image. Okay, so all your stringies, you're just going to apply that effect, just draw the paths. Yeah, pretty easy stuff. So I'm going to position this up a bit. And now the other type of animation is scaling. You know, this is all very easy stuff. It's just a matter of putting it all together. So, yeah. So we'll get rid of this. And we'll select our first leaf, which is going to animate, which will be this one. I want everything to be timed, and this is going to, you know, bounce up once this reaches there, and then the next one will scale up, and these all kind of bounce up into place. And yeah, it'll be awesome. So I think it was the bottom one here. Yeah. First thing you want to do is take the pan from behind tool and change that anchor point right to there, and hit S to bring up scale. And, you know, around about time where it gets there, you want to make this nothing, zero, hit the stopwatch to make a keyframe, shift page down, that's 10 frames, maybe it's a bit much, page up a couple times, and make it, like, overshoot it, I'll make it 113, and then I'll just hit page down, like, 4 or 5 times, and make it 100. Okay, now just select all these keyframes, F9 to smooth out the motion, and Control C to copy them, because we're going to be using these same ones on every leaf, conveniently. So yeah, just find the next leaf, and we want to, maybe once it starts, once it's at its peak, I'll have the other one start to scale in. Roundabouts, you know, you can play with that as much as you want, and just Control V. Paste those in, but take a step back and move that anchor point, or else it's going to look weird. Don't forget that. Okay, and again, paste them in. Much better. Okay, and same thing once that one's at about there. I'll select the next leaf in line, which is you, and change the anchor point. Oops. I grabbed the anchor point for the stem there. Okay, and paste. And just go around. You know, I'm sure you get the general idea now, but I'm just going to finish this off to say I did. And what the heck, we'll even grab the middle little dot there and scale him up. Alright, I tried to do a RAM preview, but yeah, my computer still sucks. Nothing's changed there. It will soon, though, I hope. And then we'll get into some real flow tutorials. Woohoo! But yeah, I mean, that's it. That sort of stroke effect, and everything bounces into place, and you know, the birds are chirping, and the sun's shining, and kids are playing with balloons and frisbees, and everything's great. So, let's do one more layer new solid. Make it white, and we'll grab, I don't know, we'll grab this one here. Copy and paste. And as I said, it's usually just one element, right? Man, this will be easy. I'll just take this in, and I'll just kind of position it down here, and just time it so once that stroke hits about there, we'll say, good enough, and those same scale properties we can just copy and paste. You know, start renaming your layers, you know, it'll get easy from here. I mean, once you take it to a point, you can pre-compose it, and then just, yeah, use it in a bigger animation. So, that's the basic idea. You can, like, this is endless. You can do whatever you want. And my anchor point's kind of off there, so you might want to pay better attention to that than I did. But, yeah, I hope you found that useful, and I'll probably be back with some more tutorials soon. Yeah, hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you later.